You mentioned that you're not the best at making opening statements, but clearly your squad out there with a final score like that, was that sort of the plan stepping onto the field, out the gate, at home for the opener?
I think that's a plan every time. You know, I mean, ideally, you start on defense, you want to get a three and out in a punt situation, get decent field position and go score. You start on offense, you want to go the length of the field, and this time it happened to be a one-play sequence on offense. That's not going to happen every week, you know, so everybody wants that, but that's not what's going to happen where you have a one-play drive to start the game. But that certainly helps. That kind of, you know, throws a little juice in the arm, and everybody kind of starts, you know, getting a little bit more excited. Defense wants to make plays now, you know, after coming off a one-play series on offense. But certainly those guys played great. Gage led us and will continue to lead us, and we'll ride him as long as we can ride him. But he had a cast of characters that played really well around him, but you're only as good as a quarterback no matter what offense you run. And so I'm just really, really proud of those guys. They played well, and the challenge is to at least reach and or exceed that level as we go week in and week out. And it'll start tomorrow morning as we take a look at NAU on film.
How do you address concerns that you have after a win like this? Obviously, penalties and turnovers. Mm-hmm. Anything you could chalk up to, you know, opening day jitters, or is it something you want to address before it could possibly hurt you the next time?
Yeah, I think the first game is a tough eval. If you just have one evaluative measure, that's for us anointing ourselves as awesome after one game, that's absurd. And so that to me is the challenge. When you have a good day, when you score a ton of points, when you don't give up a ton of points, there's a long way to go, and it's not 10 weeks ahead of us, it's 1 week ahead of us. So yes, we want to savor every victory. The victories are hard. Half of the country loses every week. Half. Not a quarter, not a third. Half of the country loses. So we are on the other half of things, and so that's important for us to enjoy the night in terms of the victory, because those are hard to come by. But then tomorrow, understand that those things aren't just going to happen week in and week out without some hard work. So we've got our work cut out, not only next week, but for weeks to go. But it is a huge challenge. There's some things on the field that we need to make sure we challenge the student athletes, but there's also some things off of the field to make sure that, you know, if this is what we really talk about, if we're going to talk about it, let's be about it. But for competitors, it's usually easy, because competitors don't rest on laurels. And so if we call ourselves a competitive bunch, we think we're going to be a competitive bunch for weeks to come, then we need to start employing competitive characteristics now and not wait to the future.
New season, new attitude. How do you feel moving forward to next week?
I feel like we're 1-0. You know, next week, you know, I'd like to, you know, kiss my kids, and my wife see me about 3 hours all week, and so I'll be able to hug her and see if she looks the same when I see her tonight. I'm just excited for the guys, the coaching staff, the support staff. There's a lot more to the story than just going out there and running plays and scoring points and not giving up a ton of points. There's a lot of people that are involved in the enterprise of a Saturday, setting up the field, breaking down the field, playing on the field, you know, keeping people off the field. There's a lot of people to thank, and we'll continue to challenge ourselves to be better day in and day out, week in and week out. But let's savor this one. Eagle Nation's proud. We're 1-0. Played well on Labor Day. I don't remember the last time we played on Labor Day weekend at home, so it's a special venue. Can't wait for the kids once we get here and open it up again, Cal Poly Week a few weeks down the road. But let's savor this one, and again, then we'll study the film with next week's opponent tomorrow.